That's good, isn't
it? That's a pretty good intro.
That's a lot of fun. Hey guys, it's Dagan.
And Alex.
From PMTV UK. And it is that time of year again. Christmas has come around. Santa has risen from his cave and dragged, what's he called again? Michael Bublé, along with him for the ride. And we thought we'd come along too, because it's been one hell of an interesting year for musical gear, hasn't it?
It has been a pretty good year for gear. I mean, on this channel, Dagan, we've probably reviewed hundreds of products.
Oh yeah, at least 140,000
I think that's
products, if that. Yeah. Starting all the way back at the NAMM show when they fired me and Nathan, essentially Russell Brand and James Corden, over to the NAMM show in California to talk about all the fun new guitar stuff, tech stuff, media stuff, drum stuff, stuff that flashes and stuff that makes noise, all the way through to now. And it's quite fun to see how those things kind of pan out during the year, isn't it?
It certainly is, yeah. And obviously you'll be going back there in a couple of months, well, less than a month's time to see what's new for
2019. I know, it's crazy.
Before we take a look at all of those extra 140,000 products,
yes,
why don't we take a look at five or six bits of our favourite gear from this year into a nice little condensed best of highlights gear of 2018.
Exactly. So here it is, our five favourite bits of gear for 2018, including cats. We're getting a little far ahead of ourselves there, because it is not just us that make videos for this fantastic PMTV UK YouTube channel. We also have five of Sam's best videos for when he works them out in his little cave down in Portsmouth, obviously miles away from us here in Newcastle.
About as far as the land goes.
As far as the land goes in the UK, we have the lovely, handsome Sam down there making the most informative videos I've seen on YouTube. My videos, I like having lots of fun with, and you enjoy making them and
stuff. Oh, it's always a laugh, mate, that's for sure, yeah.
He's a lot more detailed. He's very smart.
He knows his stuff. Great player as well.
Great player.
Not that you're not digging, you're also a good player.
Well, no, if you look closely, you will realise that I play the same thing in every video. But you seem to enjoy it, and I have lots of fun doing it. And like I said, this year has been fantastic for gear. So, let's get into ours, before Sam's, favourite bits of gear. Stick around as well, because after we talk about our favourite stuff, I will be going through some of my favourite nasty mean comments you guys have said about me this year, the same as last year. There's been some absolute corkers this year as well, hasn't there?
There's been a few.
Oh, you guys are awful.
Right, so first bit of favourite gear from this year. I'm going to steal your limelight, Dagan, straight away.
Feel free, go for it.
It's always you in front of the camera.
Enjoy.
So I really enjoyed the orange Brent Hinds Tura signature head that we filmed a few months ago.
That was a cool thing because it was something kind of different for Orange. Orange don't really do that many signature heads, and if they do, it's kind of just a little bit more gain, like the Jim Root one.
Yes.
And stuff that, well, that's already an Orange head. But with Brent, he's used so many different amps over the years. This one kind of had a bit more mid-focus to it. Like, Oranges are usually very thick, very full-sounding, lots of the best fuzz you've ever heard in your life, but... Oh. It's Brent. Brent's on the chimney. Dressed as the world's most aggressive-looking Santa Claus, saying, thank you for liking my amp.
Anyways. Meanwhile, while my house just falls to bits.
Anyways, the amps are fantastic. A bit more mid-punch. There's EL84s in them, which is quite cool for Orange. So even if you're not really a big Brent Hinds fan, or a fan of Mastodon, they're a very unique sound in Orange, super portable as well, and very loud for how small they are.
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's not get over the fact as well, they do look the part because they've got all of his face tattoos all over it, and he originally wanted to be called the Dirty Behind. Brent Hinds, Dirty Behind.
Nice.
But I think the big wigs at Orange said...
The marketing department might have thought, no, we can't be having that.
No. Next up, it has to be for me, those little Laney mini amps.
Oh, they were brilliant.
They were awesome. They were so part of the seven...
Mini amps that don't suck.
Yeah. It's quite cool as well, because they haven't been out for long, and I wasn't really too clued up on them, but I knew they did a lot of things, and I hadn't played one on Excess. Downloaded the app into your phone and stuff, and I was blown away.
Yeah, when you did that, when you downloaded the app, and somehow, through witchcraft, managed to change all the settings and, you know, go through like this library of perfectly curated sounds from your favourite bands and songs and stuff.
Yeah.
That was awesome.
So
So not only is it every kind of sound you'd want, there's also chorus effects, delay effects, loads of different effects besides the delay, which is already in the fantastic amplifier. You also get all the effects of your favorite tunes.
Through a simple aux cable, you can get any sound you want, and it's not as in like, let's get a death metal sound, let's get a John Mayer sound. You can pick and choose. It's fantastic, and they're very cheap as well. They've made a lot of people's Christmases this year.
We've gone and got ourselves some refreshments, some nice carbonated
beverages,
and that actually segues quite nicely into my next favourite bit of gear from this year, which was, in fact, not just one bit of gear, but the entire range of Landlord Effects pedals.
They're absolutely mint.
Yeah.
It's crazy because back in the day, small pedals did kind of suck. You'd have them and you'd enjoy the fact you've got a cheap pedal, have it for a little while and it would just break on you. Then you'd probably just buy another one, but that's utterly redundant. Mm-hmm. So when you get these tiny little pedals that do so much and sound so good and are so varied in the range of things they do.
Yeah, definitely.
For the price ranges, there's nothing else better really. Right, I've got to say now, thank you everyone out there, because about a year, well over a year ago now, we released the video of the 7 best cheap guitars that don't suck.
Yes.
And as of right now, just before Christmas 2018, it is pushing 1.2 million views on this year's YouTube.
Thank you guys.
We just did that as a bit of a laugh, so I could play some cheap guitars and be like, this is what's great guys, I hope you're enjoying it. Like, these ones never really get played in guitar stores because people think certain things are good and cheap, but it's doing really well, and because of that, I think my fourth favorite video of the year is the continuation of the 6 more cheap guitars that don't suck, which is 4 or 5 months old now, and it's pushing 200,000.
Yeah, we had a really good range of guitars in there, didn't we? Personally, I really liked the Epiphone Dot. Mm-hmm. That was a cool thing, because, I mean, those guitars are beautiful works of art, really, but obviously, you know, the Gibson models and stuff sometimes can be a bit pricey for some people. So what better way to kind of have an entry into that type of guitar with something that genuinely plays and sounds awesome?
With that as well, though, with the expensive thing, they did look exactly the same when Epiphone Dots were made in the USA in the 60s, and those ones sell for £12,000-£15,000 now, exactly. And these ones, Epiphone Dots, are exactly the same now. Yeah, the Gretsch Jet Club was great as well. Single cut, cheap Gretsch thing. That was fantastic. Single cut.
Just Gretsches look awesome. And I mean, if you can get something that looks, again, and sounds that good for that kind of money, it's
definitely.
Like,
they're just like a Cadillac guitar, aren't they? Black, gold, cream and stuff. Fantastic little things.
And kind of at the other end of the spectrum, more sort of Nirvana-y Kurt Cobain territory, we had the Squire Vintage Modified Mustang as well, which was awesome.
It's one of my favourite guitar colours out there, that cool kind of creamy yellow.
Yeah.
It just makes it look nice and vintage, even besides the whole grunge thing. If you're a surf guy, I want to get any kind of like lovely, clean, single coil twanginess, Mustangs are where it's at.
That's a good point about all of these guitars as well, is that we sort of deliberately picked things that were pretty versatile. I mean, all of these guitars have like a bit of a stereotype and a bit of a cult following for certain genres things, but ultimately they do all do different things, don't they?
Like, you can play any variant of music on the Epiphone Dots and stuff, but not just Oasis, even though I do think I sang Oasis. In that video.
Yes.
Because I had a guy come into PMT Newcastle a few days ago, and we're like, you're the chap from the videos, aren't you? I'm like, yes, I am. I saw you sing when you played that dot. I was like, oh, God.
You know that I'm going to put that singing in right now as well. Walking on by.
And last, but certainly not least, but definitely the loudest, is the hand-wired Vox AC30.
Oh man, that was an experience that night, filming that. I think everyone in Newcastle heard us demoing
it's
that.
It's one of my most favourite videos I've ever done, because I finally got a chance to turn up a Vox AC30, like a one that's designed the same as the ones from the 60s.
Yeah.
The new ones are amazing amps, but when you play those, I think like £3,700 for those amps, and we were absolutely caning it.
amazing. I know I'm biased because I work in a guitar store, but this is absolutely amazing. You've got to come in and try one out for yourselves, because this coming across on YouTube is going to be all compressed, coming through your phone speakers and stuff. It's shifting so much air. It's making all the guitars around me sing out to me. Play me through it next. Please play me through it next.
Genuinely made him really giddy, because I think you'd had a full day in the store as well. So obviously sometimes as I'm setting up and stuff, it could take a little bit to kind of muster up Dagan's energy again for these videos. But as soon as he kind of plugged it in and played an A and it was turned up to like 3, but it was shaking all the guitars.
All the guitars were shaking. It was like the walls were shaking. Yeah. People outside were banging on the windows because I just kept playing loads of Queen. It was so good. One of the loudest, and I'm going to say, even though I'm a Marshall guy, the best sounding amp I've heard in a long time.
You've heard it here, folks.
I love that hand-wired AC30. So there we have it, guys. Those were mine and Alex's 5 favourite bits of gear from this year, 2018.
Mm-hmm. We had a lot of contenders, but I think that's a pretty good shortlist.
Can I just quickly butt in and apologise for something as well? My little microphone has been caught on my jewels.
So he's just like, he's like one of them jesters, you know, who like cuts about in the medieval towns and that, and he's like jingle jangling. That's what it's like when we're filming, but obviously, because I'm part of this video, don't have my headphones in, didn't notice that.
Yeah,
sorry,
so
guys.
Apologies if that's
sorry
a jingle
for the quality
jangle.
Control issues. But yeah.
Speaking of quality control, let's go over to Sam, who is way more professional than me and knows his stuff, to check out his 5 favourite bits of gear from 2018. Have it, you handsome bugger.
Thanks, Dagan. Merry Christmas to you, good sir. Hope you guys are having a good one. So, if you're watching this and you haven't seen any of my videos before, I'm Sam. I suppose you could say I'm kind of a more boring, nerdier, definitely uglier and less charismatic version of Dagan. And I make a lot of the kind of in-depth, geeky reviews and gear guides on this channel. So this is my top 5 favourite bits of gear that I had the most fun filming with in 2018. Let's take a look. So, in no particular order, my first pick for my Gear of the Year list is the Boss Katana Air. Now, we all know that the Katana amps sound absolutely fantastic and offer great value for money, and the Air is no different, bringing that same awesome Katana tone to a small, lightweight stereo practice amp. And because it's fully wireless, it runs on batteries and it's got a digital wireless system, so you don't need a guitar cable, it means you can take it pretty much anywhere, which was really convenient because when it arrived back in the summer, we were experiencing a heatwave here in the UK and it was far too hot to film anything in the studio. So it gave me a great excuse to take the review al fresco. So me and the Katana went for a day out at the beach. So my next pick for my list was actually only just recently released. It's the Fender American Performer Series, which arrived just a couple of weeks ago. Now, the American Performer Series has replaced the now discontinued American Specials as Fender's most affordable range of all American made guitars. But there was one guitar in particular that caught my eye, and that's this one, the Humbucker Telecaster. Now, one of my favourite guitarists of all time is Graham Coxon from Blur, and I've always fancied getting my hands on one of his signature models, but unfortunately they're quite rare. But this guitar is about the next best thing. I've absolutely fallen in love with it. So Santa, I think I've been a good boy. Thank you. Next up, I've chosen the Electro-Harmonix Op Amp Big Muff. Now, this is a reissue of the original Op Amp Fuzz, which famously became the kind of signature sound for Billy Corgan on the first few Smashing Pumpkins albums. So, being a child of the 90s, a real grunge era kid, this was right up my street. That tone instantly took me back to my teenage years, and it featured pretty heavily on our How to Sound Like the Smashing Pumpkins gear guide. The penultimate bit of gear on my list was also central to one of our How to Sound Like guides, and that's the Martin Ed Sheeran Divide Signature Edition that you can see hanging up behind me. Now, I'm not going to make out that I'm an Ed Sheeran super fan or anything like that, I'm probably a bit too old and uncool, but there is no denying that Ed is currently one of the biggest pop stars on the planet. So as part of our gear guide, we thought it would be fun to set our Mega Challenge. She's a little bit younger and trendier than me, so Merry Christmas, Meg.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
So we challenged Meg to give me a musical makeover to see if she could help me sound a bit more like Ed Sheeran. And throughout the filming of that video, I grew quite fond of that little travel guitar. So I've got my guitar, I've got my loop pedal, I think I'm ready to give it a go.
Wait a minute, Sam, you don't look much like a pop star. You've got crap hair, rubbish clothes, and you haven't even got any tattoos. Don't worry, I've got it covered.
Whoa, that's better, isn't it?
It'll have to do.
I suppose there's only one thing left to say. I'm Sam from Professional Music Technology, but tonight, Matthew, I'm going to be Ed Sheeran.
She sells guitars in a music shop. She taught me how to loop and how to beatbox. Showed me all the things I'd need to be an Ed Sheeran wannabe. My guitar store girl. She's a pretty guitar store girl.
One last thing, Sam. You need to learn to rap.
Are you serious? There's no way that I can rap.
Ed Sheeran's really good at rapping. He raps on every song.
I'm not doing a f***ing rap.
Dance to the beat that booms, blowing up brains like a poisonous mushroom, deadly. When you hear a dumb melody, anything less than the best is a felony. Love it or leave it, you better make way.
I'm still not very cool, am I? So last but definitely not least on my gear of the year list is the Roland AX Edge. Now, this keytar is a total guilty pleasure for me. Come on, what's not to love about it? And it gave me the perfect excuse to do something that I've been wanting to do since I started filming videos for this channel, and that's to dress up and dance around like a ridiculous 1980s pop star. So that was my top 5 favourite bits of gear from 2018. I'm going to pass you back over to Dagan now because I know what you're thinking. Who the f*** is this guy nattering on? We came here to watch Dagan. Look, I know he's got a bit of a cult following. Even I want to watch more Dagan. I'll admit it, I'm a Daganist. Daganism. I came up with that. Hashtag I'm a Daganist. Hashtag Daganism. You never know. If we get that trending now, maybe in 2,000 years, we'll be celebrating Daganmas instead of Christmas. But I digress. Before I go, I just want to wish a very Merry Christmas to everyone out there who's watched one of our videos over the past 12 months. Thanks for all the likes and the mostly positive, nice comments, and I look forward to making more videos for you in 2019. So Dagan, it's back over to you. And cut. Cheers, Sam, that'll do. Can I take this stupid thing off now?
Wow, thank you, man. I don't really know what to say to something like that. It was intense, but in a really nice way. But don't say you're ugly or anything, come to Newcastle and there'll be loads of lovely Geordie women if you are dying to have a little play with that goatee of yours. It's good. I always appreciate a good, well-sculpted, facial-haired man.
Absolutely.
Yeah, and he's a better guitar player than me. But on that high, we must now go to an intense low, and I'm going to read through, well, we're going to read through some of your nastiest comments of 2018.
Yes, the depths of despair. Yeah. All right, Diergun. Okay. I've got the list here. Are you ready?
Nope.
There's quite a few this year. We had a whole team of people working to collate all of these mean
Yeah, I'm sure PMT
comments.
Had to employ another warehouse full of people just to go through all the Russell Brand comments.
We've printed
alone.
We've printed off all of these mean comments and got them on placards and stored them in a warehouse just because they're so
Yeah, and
brilliant.
At the end of every year, I burn the warehouse down with my family. And we all cook s'mores on the top of it.
Right. Wacker.
Just wacker.
Yep.
Well, are you bleeping this? Yes.
I'll have to bleep
Okay, so it's this, essentially.
Might have to bleep that as
Might
well.
Might have to bleep that. You could bleep that. It's a W and then what you throw off the side of a ship to keep it in port, I guess.
Great description.
That's awful. Thank you, man. Thank you.
Please fire this guy.
I literally picked my phone up to look at it and you just hit us with another one. Why fire me? Who would you rather watch? Me or someone else?
Don't ask that.
I didn't know what to say. Diergun, you're so saturated. It's almost impossible to watch and hear your piercing voice. Maybe some, in brackets, most, people won't buy this amp for your quasi-metal shit. But for something more mainstream. You could be a good rock, hard rock guitar player. Sorry, I've never heard of you, but your demonstration is crap.
That's lengthy.
Who takes that much time to do that? One thing I want to say as well, we're not really including that many Russell Brand comments this year.
Yeah.
Or Jack Sparrow comments.
Just because when we try and collect them, it just crashes all the computers and stuff.
The amount of comments we've got saying, I didn't know Russell Brand played guitar. I didn't know Jack Sparrow played guitar. This looks like Russell Brand was stuck on an island with Jack Sparrow and the couple had a child that was digging.
Why do your mannerisms have to evoke a crack addict? Please calm down.
Nice job, you made all that equipment sound like poop. What a rookie, and I'd say it's called the pelt, I know where this is from now, due to an animal pelt, or in other words, fur. Fur is a common adjective to describe a fuzz tone, i.e. the orange fur coat fuzz pedal. Well, Dominic.
So this was from the Fender.
It's from the pelt.
The pelt.
Yes.
Review, right?
It is actually called the Pelt because it was designed and made in a little village called Pelton Fell, which is just next to Chesterley Street up here in the northeast of England. That was a lie.
I know a pelt is a bit of... I know the pelt's not called a pelt because it was derived in a place called Pelton Fell, which is about a 5-minute drive from here in the northeast of England. I'm sorry your grand intellect couldn't get the satire of what I was doing, but I know. This is really good before we get really dark again. Love the video, Diergun for Prime Minister. Imagine me as the Prime Minister.
No, oh, I couldn't, mate.
Name one would have tops on. Diergunisms by my count. Diergunisms, that's already a thing.
That is a thing.
That is a thing. I said lovely 29 times. I do say lovely a lot. I say lovely and fantastic a lot. Classic ones, we all know and love. No times, let's just gloss over the fact I said know and love. If you want to know why I don't say know and love anymore, go to the last year's mean comments video and realize why I don't say know and love anymore. Sustained for days once, legendary once, and all, and my all-time favourite Diergunism, it looks the business.
I can just picture, like, because you often mention in videos, like, what, you know, wherever you're watching this video, whether it's on your phone, on the TV, or whether you're sitting on the toilet, and I think, let's be honest, probably 90% of people are going to be on the can. I can just imagine him kind of sitting there with his phone in one hand, and then, like, a tally chart in the other, and being like...
On the toilet paper.
Yeah, yes. Being like, lovely. Oh, there's another one there. Yeah. Oh, another lovely.
That's great.
Kate Tremaine wants a Diergun for Christmas. And 56 people agree with her.
Well, there's only one Diergun.
You don't come cheap.
Unfortunately, I already have a lovely lady. But I suppose in a few years' time, when cloning's a thing, I can give you all the misfortune of having one for yourselves.
Imagine if you had a Diergun with you all the time. Imagine how irritating that would
be. I basically do. You're on my computer screen all the time.
Yeah, you poor man.
His hair.
Is his hair just the only comment?
That's it. From Joshua Lechuga.
I think I know where this is from, and it's absolutely ridiculous. This is from the 11 best gifts for guitar players. And I was having a bad hair day. It happens. I'm paranoid about having one now. And my hair kind of went up for like 2 inches. And then just jelly waterfall down my face, and you might have comments just going like, wow, that's one hell of a hairstyle. That's an awful hairstyle. Like, I'm sorry, it wasn't my fault.
And we also, I think, was this on the same video? We had a few people saying that actually he resembled Lord Farquaad from Shrek.
Yes.
Didn't Lord Farquaad played guitar?
You know, hair was awful that day, but it was very shiny. And Lord Farquaad has a great jaw.
He does, yeah.
Great jaw.
Great jawline.
Big house. Like, he's probably got other houses, like, dotted around wherever Shrek's from.
I think we better wrap this up pretty quickly, Dagan.
Yes, because we could go on for hours.
We could. But I'll give you another one here. No offence, but you are an awful bass player. Makes these demos worthless. It's so bad.
Yeah. My bass playing isn't great. Like, I like doing these videos, and I love bass, and I love bass amps, and I love bass pedals, and I love basses that don't suck. But I'm not fundamentally a bass player, and I get a lot of crap for that.
I tell you what, though, recently we filmed some videos which we can't tell you about yet. But
yes.
Shortly into the new year, we did dig up a pretty damn awesome bass player to help us film some
guitar videos. We did, and it went really well.
It did.
So instead of me playing bass, we've got a fantastic bass player named Heath playing some lovely basses for you, which you'll have to get subscribed to the PMTV UK YouTube channel for to see what we have in store for the start of 2019. Right, so let's wrap it up with my final mean comment. And it's nothing to do with me. I've been getting grief for years doing these videos. And Alex has got his first nasty comment.
What?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
I'm not even in them. I'm only in these ones.
It's from a guy called Frantisca.
Oh God.
And it says, Santa, please offer a video editor to PMT. Which cuts.
Oh, come on.
Deep. It's
why?
Straight,
what video was that from?
Straight for the jugular.
Where was that from?
I'm sure it's one of the recent ones. One of the, like, 11 best... all 11.
It was the gift guide.
The gift guide, yeah. Slash
that
worst hairstyle.
That was what it was.
Yeah.
I'm speechless.
I think it's edited together lovely.
There's
a few things you could have done better here and there. But
oh, come on.
On the whole, it's lovely.
That video has... It has nice titles, it's got nice transitions. Mm-hmm. I even did some like motion tracking stuff, getting like really geeky now, I know, sorry, but oh man, this is a bit weird. I'm not
That's
used to
fantastic.
Having comments like this.
I love it.
I can only imagine how you feel, mate.
Please comment some more nasty comments about Alex. So this time next year, please pick apart his video editing skills and no, please don't. He's fantastic. He's the reason that this is a thing. Like, I wouldn't be able to do any of this without you. I'd just be harping on to a camera in the bathroom without any pants on. I wouldn't know what to do.
that might catch on, to be fair.
That might catch on.
You might want to do that in some ways.
You might want to do that like alongside PMT, you just have Dagan's bathroom conversations, talk about how people should fight us if they don't like the DS1.
If that sounds like good YouTube entertainment to you, leave a comment. I think this will take off, I really do.
I think it's great. But anyways, thank you so much for watching all the videos.
Thank you.
That we had to offer on PMTV UK. Thank you so much to Sam, Meg, Nathan,
Al Murray
came in because he's got the British Drum Company, hasn't he?
That's right, yep.
It's fantastic, man. Thank you guys so much for watching over this past year. Here's to another year, 2019. Some more fantastic stuff for myself and all the rest of the guys at PMT. Thank you, Alex.
Thank you, Dagan.
For letting me in your house again and talking to your cameras and letting me stroke your cats.
You're very welcome. They're a bit less energetic this year.
Yeah, they've got more hair than my cat as well.
Yeah, quite a bit more. Yeah. But there we go. Thank you so much, guys. If you want any info on any of the gear that we've spoke about either in this video or in any of the hundreds of videos that we've made this year, then go to pmtonline.co.uk. Alternatively, what can they do, Dagan?
Call into one of our forever expanding and beautiful PMT stores. We've got loads now up and down the country. There's got to be one near you. Call in and try out some of these things for yourselves. We are Twitter. Well, even PMT, because we are Twitter. We are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Please give us a like and a follow to see pictures of everything I've spoke about and myself and Alex, but with lovely, lovely filters on.
So that's it. Thanks so much for watching. All the best. Merry Christmas.
Here's to a cracking 2019.
Indeed.
Have a good one, guys.
See you later.
See you later.